Hey guys, welcome to the series of learning Verilog A, the analog hardware description language. Watch this series to get the full knowledge on Verilog A. Hey guys, welcome to the first episode on Verilog A. In this episode, we are going to talk about why Verilog A language was created, strong bonding between SPICE and Verilog A, correlation of Verilog, Verilog A and Verilog AMS, basics of Verilog A, modeling approaches along with examples. So let's begin. Why the Verilog A language was created? It was created to face the competition from VHDL AMS. OVI, the body that standardized Verilog, also standardized Verilog AMS, a single language covering both analog and digital design. Verilog A is a true analog subset of the Verilog AMS language. High-level hardware description language. This is for analog designs. Now let's come to the SPICE and Verilog A correlation and their dependency. We know that SPICE is a very widely used language for analog design. So SPICE is very good for transistor level analog circuit modeling, but it is difficult to model high level system behaviors. Also, there is a limitation that SPICE model cards are dependent on BSIM, that is Berkeley short channel IGFET model, compact models. Original versions of BSIM models were written in C programming languages. Now let's come to an interesting point here where the Verilog A comes into the picture, which joins SPICE and Verilog A. All new versions of the model support only Verilog A. This is I am talking about the BSIM models, except BSIM 4 and BSIM 3. Now let's see which are the latest BSIM models. The various BSIM compact models available as per today are BSIM CMG, common multi-gate that is used for FinFET technologies, BSIM IMG, independent multi-gate, BSIM SOI that is used for FDSOI or UTSOI technologies, BSIM bulk, also known as BSIM 6, it is used for bulk CMOS technologies, and BSIM 4, which is used from 0.13 micrometer down to 20 nanometer nodes. So now we saw that how wide these BSIM compact models are, which actually contribute to creating a SPICE model card. And nowadays, these all BSIM things are modeled, the compact modeling is done by Verilog A. So let's see a snippet how things are done inside a BSIM model, model card generation. So this is a snippet of Verilog A definition for BSIM 4. For a MOSFET, we know that a SPICE model is defined like model name, the instance name, then the sequence of the nodes are DGSB, drain, gate, source and body. Then comes the model name, that comes from the .lib model card, and the parameters, that is length, width, AD, AS, PD, PS. So these are basic things that will be there these models, model parameters ALWADASPDPS, this will be there for any model card. If you open a .lib containing the model cards, this will be the first things you will see. So let's see a snippet how Verilog A is used for the calculation. So here there is a case is used for calculating the PSPD ASAD. So this is just a snippet, so the entire code is huge, and so this way the Verilog A compact modeling helps to generate the MOSFET model cards for our latest day SPICE models. So now come to just talk about the Verilog A and Verilog MS. Now when we think of Verilog, first the language that comes to our mind is Verilog, which is used in digital designs. And in college, we usually get familiar with Verilog, that is for digital design. Now, the Verilog AMS and Verilog A, these are highly professional area and they are mostly used in the industry. So let's see how the three languages are interconnected. Verilog. The simulations are discrete event or discrete value. The Verilog, it is continuous in time or continuous value simulation because it is for analog. Analog values will change with time. That is what we have, what we usually do in a transient simulation in SPICE, that with time being in the x-axis, another voltage or current being in the y-axis, and we see how the waveform changes with time as per the analog functions of the circuit. Signal flow architecture. I'll come to later point what these architectures are. Conservative architecture. So there are two different architecture of Verilog A modeling. One is a signal flow, another is the conservative. Now let's come to see the what is a Verilog AMS. It is a superset of Verilog and Verilog A. So the Verilog we know from the beginning, and the Verilog A that is used for analog, when combined together, no, not combined together, the Verilog AMS will have something more. Support both discrete event and continuous time simulations. So in Verilog we have discrete event, and in Verilog A we have continuous. So both features are there in Verilog AMS. Supports both system and circuit level modeling. Now comes the interesting part. There are extra features to AMS apart from Verilog A and Verilog. Is number one, discrete event and continuous value simulation. This makes compatible this Verilog AMS to use both the Verilog and Verilog A syntaxes for simulations. And mostly for this simulation, what I am talking about is a analog digital co-simulation or analog digital mixed mode simulation. This there are multiple terminologies are spread over the industry. So anything you can pick up where an analog and a digital are simulated together. The second point is a very important part. Automatic interface element insertion. So interface element is a particular element that actually stays in the boundary of the digital and analog, and it helps to convert one into the another. Okay, so here we cover the relation, correlation, interconnection of Verilog, Verilog A and Verilog AMS. Let's move on to the next slide. So before going further, we, as we know that Verilog AMS is a bit different from Verilog Digital. So what makes it different? Here, disciplines and natures are defined specific for analog circuits. Now, the discipline associate potential and flow together. The nature are the collection of attributes that can describe the units, absolute tolerance, convergence, and names of the potential and flow access functions. So let's exemplify. Here, we will use a type electrical, which is actually a discipline. This discipline contains both potential and flow. Potential is voltage and flow is current. Now, this voltage and current, how they are defined? They are defined as nature. Nature current is defined is with the symbol, its unit and tolerance value. The voltage is defined as with the symbol, unit is volt and its tolerance. Simply, we also have power. Its symbol is PWR, unit is watt, and there is a tolerance. Now, these are different from the digital Verilog definition. So these discipline and nature, these are introduced in Verilog AMS, and these are used in Verilog A, as Verilog is the subset of Verilog AMS. Now, apart from these things, there is one more thing that is not present in the digital. That is temperature. Yes, analog circuit behavior depends on temperature. In SPICE, we usually define the temperature temp with the temp keyword. So here the nature is defined as temperature. Its symbol is temp. Okay. And that we can see the unit and the tolerance also. Temperature here is defined in Kelvin. Okay, and the tolerance we can get here. So these are the new set of disciplines and nature that is different from the Verilog. And now let's move on to the basics. Okay, so when we are talking about Verilog A, let's now focus on to Verilog A only. And for a while, let's keep apart the Verilog that is used for digital. So here in Verilog A, current and voltage values are calculated simultaneously by Kirchhoff's laws. We know KCL and KVL from our college days. KVL, that is the potential around a loop, must sum to a zero. KCL is flows into a node must be sum to zero. So KVL and KCL are considered in Verilog A. Values varies continuously with time, so they are in analog nature. So when we see a waveform like this, we know that with time it varies continuously. At this waveform, the value of the y value is different at different time points, where time is independent in the x-axis. Supports both electrical and non-electrical signals. A new type of process, analog statement, is introduced here. This is a block that continuously applied. It's like a assign statement in Verilog. It's similar to the assign statement we used in Verilog. So later we will see this analog block and we'll understand how it is continuous. So this is the basic structure of Verilog we have just talked about, what the things are in there, and before that we have seen that what discipline and nature are already introduced in Verilog A. Now let's see the modeling approach, means when we are writing a Verilog A model, the approaches that we use. The first approach is a conservative modeling. Here model relates potential and flows, and the device modeling and loading at interfaces. So definitely there will be this thing. These are analog circuit, so these factors are considered here. This is called conservative modeling, and this is way very similar to the SPICE modeling that we do. Okay, the difference with this, how we find in the next kind of modeling, is a signal flow modeling. Here in the signal flow modeling, we have two words, signal and flow. That is means flow of signals. So model relates to potentials only, and this is useful for abstract model. So here the flow will go from one point to another point. We'll come to the examples later on, and this will get properly explained. And the third approach is that we can combine these two, the conservative modeling and the signal flow modeling. Okay, let's move to the conservative modeling. With conservative systems, it is also useful to define the concept of a branch. A branch is a path of flow between two nodes through a component. Every branch has an associated potential and flow, and obviously there will be potential between potential difference between the two nodes. So we can see in the picture here, there are two nodes, and in between the two nodes, when we go from one node to another node, the thing is called a branch. Now let's see the nature of the node and details. A node is an interconnection point assumed to be infinitesimally small. No accumulation of flow on the node. No potential difference across the node. Branch, a path between the two nodes. No accumulation of flow on branch. So nodes where the potential will not be a potential difference, and in branch accumulation will not be there, but at the two ends we will see the potential difference. Okay, let's understand this conservative modeling by a simple example. It's a resistor. So here two nodes are A and B of a resistor. Here we define these two nodes as electrical, and we also define a parameter called res with the value 1. Now here our analog block starts. This is the analog block that we are talking about in couple of slides back. Here the equation, and here the less than equal to then the plus sign, this operator is called contribution operator. So here we can see the potential V between AB or the branch AB, we can say, is equal to resistor value into current between the two nodes A and B. So this is the resistor, simply V equal to IR, and the contribution operator here is a bit different. We'll see in the next example how it is different. So here our analog block ends, and this block will be in continuous in nature, so it doesn't just execute once and stops, not like that. It will be continuously operating, and with time the values will be inside this block will be executed, and the results will be reflected. Here we close our module definition by the end module. The next example, RLC parallel. Here multiple contributions will be used. So in last slide we talked about the contribution operator, that is less than and then the plus sign. It is called a contribution operator. It accumulates potential and flows to nodes, ports and branches. Order of contribution is not significant. So we can see multiple equations can be there in sequence, but overall effect will be taken into consideration, not the sequence. So let's see the our RLC parallel circuit. We can see R, L and C. Let's define node A and node B. Now we'll start writing the Verilog A code. So module RLC and our nodes are A and B. We define them to be as electrical. We define parameter R and exclude value 0. We'll see later why. Parameter C equal to 1. Parameter L equal to 1 and exclude zeros. These are the values of the resistor, capacitor and inductor. Now let's begin the analog block that will define the behavior of this RLC parallel circuit. The first equation contributes the current for going through the resistor. Second one is for capacitor. In the third, this equation contributes for inductor. So we close our analog block here. Now we can see the IAB is common in the left hand side of the three equations, and this is I is the resultant of the three different currents that is happening in R, L and C. So this is the purpose of the contribution operator. It is accumulating the current, and the sequence is not important here. We can write the inductor first and then C and then R, or any of the permutation combination. Now let me also speak why we exclude zero. Here we can see in the first equation R is in the denominator, as well as L is also at the denominator, hence we exclude 0. So this is how we excluded the case where divide by 0 condition. Now we close our module definition here by end module keyword. Signal flow modeling. So this is the another modeling approach apart from the conservative modeling that we just talked about. So here in the picture we can see from A to B, there is a flow and there is a potential is flowing, okay. In signal flow modeling, signals may be potential, that is voltages, or flows, that is currents. Signal may be floating or differential. So floating is, we know, is a dangling condition, and differential is a mathematical expression. Signal flow and conservative models may be freely interconnected. Okay, so there is no hard code boundary that we should make, that this thing has to be this thing cannot interact with the conservative, not like that. The signal flow modeling and the conservative modeling can be interacted, they can interact with each other, so they can be mixed. Need for electrical modeling at the input and output. So when this is defined, we need to define some additional electrical modeling at the input and the output, the two nodes. Signal flow systems only have one potential associated with every node, that is one flow. As a result, the signal flow terminal must be unidirectional. That is the general nature of current. When the current flows, it flows in a direction at a particular time. It may either read the potential of a node or it may specify. So we are talking about A and B in the picture here. So here A and B, so when we talk about A, it reads, and here it defines. The flow, signal flow semantics require a smaller number of equation and unknowns, so results in a formulation that more efficient to simulate. So since this signal flow modeling is very less complicated, so coding is a bit simple. So let's see how. Here we are showing the example of an amplifier that has two ports, out and in. Input is in, output is out. We define these two as voltages, and we use a parameter called gain. Now our analog block starts, and V out is the contribution of gain multiplied by V in. So this is a very well known amplifier equation, and if we change the gain parameter here, we will get different values of the amplification. So we end the block here. So this is a very simple signal flow modeling, because here we can, in the equation we can see there only the potential is flowing from in to out, and it is multiplied by a gain. We close our module definition by end module. Thank you guys, we have reached to the end of this episode, and bye. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for regular updates.